Hello, Lo-Fi Local for you up top. Episode 500 of Lo-Fi Poli-Sci is July 8th next week. Got ideas? Want to be a voice? Send me your words. Now to your regularly scheduled programming. Lo-Fi Poli-Sci coming at you, Michael Pickering here talking our famous quest. We are not talking about what's going on in the world today, but rather, I wanted to talk to you about writing a book. That's right, I'm actually doing it. The book is completely outlined. The introduction chapter is done. And this week, I'm in the middle of putting together a proposal package to send to university presses and publishers. So I kind of thought, why not talk to you about all of this? As I've had quite a few people over the past several years ask me, how does publishing in university actually work? What's the peer review process? So here we go. Firstly, this is my first book, as well as going to be my first academic publication. You know, my dissertation, which for real was a book, technically doesn't count as putting it on a CV as an academic publication, even though they are peer-reviewed by your committee in order to get your doctorate. But that was a year and a half and 224 pages ago. Now it's time for something completely different. And since I'm in the works of creating it and shopping it around to private companies / university presses, I can't tell you all that much about it. I gotta protect my own IP, people. P.S. IP, for those who don't know, means intellectual property, meaning in this case the idea of the book and its new contribution to the literature. But I can tell you the overarching theme of the book I'm writing is about media and politics around the world. I don't have a name yet. I have a few ideas, but nothing solid, though very soon I'll have to pick something from my proposals. But what actually goes into writing a book versus writing an academic journal article, for instance? Well, I can tell you one of the biggest differences would be the sheer scope of the author's idea and how it's being investigated and researched, meaning the methods we use. You know, academic journal articles are normally capped at about 40 pages double-spaced, so ideas larger than that either has to be done in multiple articles or a book. And personally, I dread writing articles, though it's coming soon enough for me, and I'll talk to you about it when it gets here for sure. But for me, my idea focuses on the relationship between media and politics around the world. And since there's about 200 countries in the world, and the way I've decided to go about it, you know, methodologically, a book, or really several books, seems like the right call for me. So what did I do after I decided that? I decided media and politics. What about it? Well, I had an idea. I flushed out that idea, made it into a workable research question with a hypothesis, and I made it very, very specific. And then I checked to make sure no one else had the exact same idea before. Because academic contributions, generally speaking, have to be new additions to the literature, period. So if your idea isn't new, it is far, far more difficult to get it published, at least in political science, though that rule is generally true in all expert fields. So I did all of that, and then I started outlining my project in the largest possible scope, you know, to see how big of a research project it would be, and I figured it would be multiple volumes. Simple as that. But then I had to decide, how was I going to split it up? And most importantly for this summer, what would I include in my first book? So I sat down, typed it out, and I decided. And then I started the process of outlining the entire book, chapter by chapter, heading by heading, subheading by subheading. Though I will tell you, I still have a lot of question marks all throughout in different places, but that way it makes it easier to shift things around if I need to, once I start the editorial process with the editor from the publisher. But then, I started cutting and pasting all my notes and thoughts of the project that related to this first book in the right places in the outline. Once that was done and I was finished with my outline completely and everything I had written or thought about or talked about was in the outline and I had nothing else to do, I went to the introduction chapter and started writing. And 11 pages later, my intro was done and my project was started. But from this point, there are generally at least two paths that authors can take. They could, one, finish writing the entire book and then shop it around to publishers. Or, two, they could start shopping it around. There are pros and cons to both of these, really. If you finish the book then, theoretically, you may be more likely to get it published quicker. But that very much depends on how well you wrote the book and how good your research is. But having the whole thing done, it might decrease your time in the editing stage. It might. Because once you get a publisher, they also generally assign you an editor, as well as send your book off to experts in the field, and they're going to have it peer reviewed. People will read it. And then the battle really begins, because piece by piece, people are picking apart your entire book. And depending on the feelings of your editor and the publisher, you could have a shit ton of edits to make, and maybe even throw out entire chapters and have to write entirely new ones because you wrote the entire thing first. But after the editing stage of your book, after it's approved and peer-reviewed, it's ready for publishing. I, obviously, because I already told you, did not go that direction. I've decided to go through door number two, thank you very much. I have my entire detailed outline done, and I have a writing sample from the book in the form of my introduction chapter, so I'm in the process of looking for publishers. That's why I'm putting together a proposal package, because every university press has guidelines for proposals. For instance, for one company I have been looking at, they have what's known as a prospectus. A prospectus is nothing more than a research proposal. But I'm going to give you the 10 details that I have to work into my proposal, or that I have to make my proposal into. Number one, a project description outlining my ideas and methods. Number two, a unique value proposition that basically says why my idea is important. Number three, the projected length of the book in word count and page count, and I'm still trying to figure out how I'm going to come up with that kind of number. Number four, I'm not even going to edit this because I always get this word mixed up, but number four is the pedagogy that my book brings to the table as far as educational values and techniques that I'll use. Pedagogy, pedagogical, what a word. Number six, a diversity, equity, and inclusion statement about how my book addresses all of these things in regards to my field. Number seven, what's my book's competitors? What other expert books am I trying to replace potentially? Number eight, estimated time to complete the project entirely, as well as estimated time to have a first draft finished. Number nine, my credentials for writing on this topic. Number 10, an annotated table of contents, where I basically take my entire outline for my table of contents, and I write at least a paragraph or more description under each heading and subheading, detailing what each chapter is about. And all of that is what I've been working on this week. So far, I've reached out to, though without sending any of my material, I've reached out to two publishing companies, and I'm waiting to hear back from them, though they may not respond until I send them something substantive, until I send me or send them an actual full proposal. We'll just kind of have to wait and see. You know, this is my first time around as well. But after my proposal package is finished this week, I'm going to start hardcore sending it out to different presses. And that's where I'm at. But what's the next step, you may be wondering? What's it really all look like? Well, I'm hoping I'll find a publisher relatively quickly. I don't really know how long this process will take. I don't. But if a publishing company likes my proposal, then they would make me an offer and send me a potential contract, which we could negotiate back and forth for the contract. But if I like the contract, I sign it, they assign me an editor, and I'm off. And every time I finish a chapter, I send it in. They send it to be peer-reviewed, and I start working on my next chapter. Once it's done, I send that one to my editor as well. They send it to be peer-reviewed, and they give me my other chapter that has already been peer-reviewed, and I address comments and concerns and make edits to the chapter as needed, then send it back to the editor. And back and forth and back and forth until all the chapters are done, they're all peer-reviewed, they're all re-edited until the entire book is finished. And then we publish. And that's writing a book in political science. Sounds so fun, right? Well, I'll be honest, for me, it actually is. When I'm in the groove, when I'm in that headspace of just writing, it's actually a lot of fun for me. You know, writing something new that's never been done before, creating research with global implications, building something to help create a better tomorrow. Well, that's exactly why I do what I do. Speak to me, people. Let me hear your voice. And it's not a cliche or a catchphrase. It's a lifestyle. Always remember that lo-fi poli-sci is more than just me. It's the we that we be. Talk to you tomorrow. Pickering, signing off.